It is one spiritual platform that will provoke another spiritual result. That's what it will be for life. One spiritual platform, they always provoke another result. That's why it's a risk for a man to say, I won't go to church. It's a risk for a man to say, I don't have an altar. If you don't have an altar, another person's altar might be speaking in your behalf. Because one platform will guarantee another result, another spiritual result. If you say a person, something that happened, now one platform, then they talk so. One spiritual platform, then they talk. That's why it's good for every man to have an altar. Altar you can cry to, altar you can talk. Lord God, let the God of this, my altar, talk for me. You must have an altar, or else your landlord altar might be speaking in your behalf. Your neighbor altar might be talking to you. That's why you must know that there is this spiritual platform that are giving birth to things. Praise the Lord. Malachi chapter 3 verse 6 said, God said there, he said, I am the Lord, I change it not. No matter your civilization, no matter what you read, God does not change. So, okay, because of civilization, no. God said, I am the Lord, and I change it not. And as we engage him in worship, as we engage him in singing, in prayer today, he will turn things around for you. He said, if you believe, Jesus told the man, he said, if you believe, you will see the glory of God. He said, if you believe, you will. So the thing is, do you believe? If you believe, you will see the glory of God. I know how it was before. I know how I started. And this word always comes to my mind. Do you believe? Is that if you believe, you will see the glory of God. If you just believe, you will see the glory of God. See, it's dangerous to make a vow with God and don't fulfill it. It's dangerous. Now you go do it by yourself. But when you do it by yourself, you involve God. It not be your vow again, because you and God. Before you start them, now you. But you start and finish, now you and God. And I risk to make vow. God say, I don't make vow with foolish people. So to make a vow and not to fulfill it, you can make it secretly, but when you finish, you say amen, become you and God. I just want to tell you a little about vow before we close, before we pray. A man traveled overseas from here. Before he traveled, he was not doing well in Alaba business. He came to me, said he wants to travel. My prayer, go on. He traveled to America. He's in his 50s. He traveled to America. I said, but you don't think your age on the go for now. How you want to travel to America at the age of 50? He said, God can do anything. I said, I believe that. After prayer, he traveled to America. He succeeded in working for some time and gathered some money. He brought a car. He sent a car to the wife. He told the wife something. He said, I want to pay a vow. I make a covenant vow with my wife and my children in that church, that if God can protect them and keep them alive and take me to America and make me succeed, this is what I would do something. I asked the wife, your husband say they make vow. He said yes. When you go redeem the vow, he said they go redeem the vow next week. I say vow is very dangerous. Nobody force you to do amo. Now you see the hand of God. Where they see, I'm not there. But where you don't see, I'm finished. I don't involve. God don't involve. So try. If not to sell your shoe, pay that vow. The woman, it is in a story, then God day. God has not changed. The woman not fulfilled the vow. 1 month ago, 2 months ago, 3 months. Papa, you are in charge. I say fully. Papa, you are in charge. I say, I knew before. The fourth month or the fifth month, the man fell sick over there. And the American doctor could not handle the man. They flew the man back to this place. As we speak, the man there for hospital bed. As we speak, the man and the wife, little thing happened. Divorce came. Just simple vow. I tell the woman, say, now that small thing, they call it vow. That small thing, then they ruin it. Then they scatter on her life. So that small thing, it be like this. Be like jiga. It's not going to make you wear shoe well. And that small thing, then hold your soul. If only you can take your tongue, count your teeth. And that small vow, what you do, your husband do, then they end now into mystery. So it won't turn life to something else. That small vow. No make vow or you know if it pay. It is dangerous. Better make you no make. Make you day where you day. Than make you make. You go up. You come day. Say, now my power, I go do it when I like. Don't make a vow you cannot redeem. You can say, God, I go clap for you. You don't go do anything. But now what do you give them? Then they tell me what you go get back. Say no. Eh? If they go say, as I finish this, I'll give you money. Let me say, go give you more money. Say no. If they say, God, I will give you clap. I will clap for you. They say, God will give you plenty strength to clap many, many times. God say, God, I go take my leg dance for you. No problem. Go stretching your leg. So you go dance, they go. Now, what do you give her? Now, they tell me what you go get back. So God is not a man somebody should joke with. God, they take person from one glory to another glory. If they stop, if they move person like that, that's how God they move person. Praise the Lord. And that's how you're going to pay your vow. Every day as a child of God, there is something you're supposed to ask yourself. Oh God, what am I supposed to do for you? That's how they do. I ask God, say, you get what I'm supposed to do when I never do. Maybe there is something, because there is something you must do to change the level. It's not just, I pay my tithe, I go. I pay my tithe, I pay, I come much. No, there is something extra to get you extra things. There is something you must still do to move to the next level. And until you do the extra, you don't get the extra. You know, I don't know whether they hear me. Anytime you desire, say, I like to get extra things, just think of the extra thing you want to do. You want to buy clothes? You want to buy clothes for usher? You want to buy chair for choir? You just do extra. If they gather all the engineers for this world, make them divide Red Sea, it will take them years before they go construct road or bridge for Red Sea. You can tell them, say, we want people to construct a dry ground in this Red Sea. It will take them years to construct road for the Red Sea. But it takes God 1 minute to construct road for Red Sea. So God is not a man. I know whether you hear me. If God can do that in a minute, he can turn your life around in a minute. So you're going to pray, Lord, this month of September, I want, Lord, turn my life around. This month of September, oh God, turn my life around. Lord, this month of September, turn my life around.